Good morning from Montrose Old and St Andrew's Church, and welcome to our short thought for the day, Thinking Outside the Box. Most of us value traditions, not necessarily the same ones. For some, it will be ensuring that we're home in time for our favourite TV programme, or we make a point of following our team, or we have a preferred takeaway meal, or we go to church at Christmas, or whatever else is on your list. We like to think that we're adaptable and that we move with the times, so it's not as though everything is written in concrete. But if truth be told, most of us don't really like change, especially when the change affects our personal preferences, perhaps run counter to our dearly held practices. We know that change is inevitable, but it can be hard to face, all the more so when it comes home to roost. Some people deny change, close their mind to it, almost taking the line that if they don't acknowledge it, it will just go away. Doesn't work, does it? Or we put it off, delay it, kick the can down the road. We might be more ready to deal with it later. Or if we're lucky, and we usually aren't, they may have changed their mind and what we'd feared isn't going to happen. That's not terribly successful either. We could engage with the changes, not exactly embracing them, but at least finding out about them, discussing, possibly having a say in them. That can be a useful strategy, though it does involve extra work. And then we could out and out embrace them. That can be very hard. But if we've engaged first, we might be in a position to embrace change, especially if we've had some influence on the change. Peter was a traditionalist and proud of it. And yet, he was willing to push the boundaries back in response to God's call to go and help non-Jewish people learn about the good news of Jesus. Initially, he recalled against the thought at breaking with the habits of a lifetime in eating unclean animals. Then his eyes were opened to see that God wasn't restricting the good news to Jewish people, but that it was open to everyone who loved and trusted Jesus. Going to Caesarea, he was amazed at how open people were to the good news of Jesus, how the Spirit had been working to change lives. It involved some out-of-the-box thinking, but it made sense. It squared with what God was doing in that largely non-Jewish city. Let's review our traditions to ensure that we're not artificially keeping people away from Jesus. Let's be more imaginative, so that we come up with strategies to take seriously God's plan to reach out to all. What might it mean for us, for our church? What can be reaffirmed in what we do as being useful for reaching out to the community? What might have had its day? There might be some surprises, but we need to be open to God's leading. How about it? Thanks for joining us. May the Lord bless you. Amen.